Now then, I hope you're all doing well. So today I'm going to be reviewing Enola, which is a scare experience over at Walsall Scare Maze. This is not a maze, this is just a scare experience, I think it's best described. However, let's get straight into it because there is so much to unpack. So it goes without saying that there will be spoilers ahead and some sexual references as well. This is an 18 plus waivered scare experience. The waiver was 2 pages long and you do have to sign it before you can take part. After I'd signed, I entered into Enola, which the first room I was greeted by a hospital waiting room. Very well themed in there. Some posters up on the wall related to the story of Enola, which is you are a patient who has agreed to a drug trial. I handed over my waiver to the nurse, answered a few questions, held my waiver up to a camera just to confirm that I was happy to go ahead and understand what I'm doing. Asked to take a seat. Got asked to take my hoodie off and put it in a plastic carrier bag. And then asked to sit in a cubicle after about two or three, maybe a minute, maybe two, I don't know. And then the nurse knocked on a door, asked if the doctor was ready to see me, and into the next room I went. So in this room, it was basically like an operating theatre where the doctor introduced himself and asked me to sit down on basically what was a best described as a dentist chair in the centre of the room. He basically asked me a few questions about what we're going to be doing during the trial, and then proceeded to pull out a needle, said that there'd be no pain, and injected me in my arm. Of course the needle wasn't real, it simply just retracted, which was a cool little effect. And then the doctor left and pulled the hospital curtain around me that was in the room and said he'd be back in a few moments. During that time, a pre-show started on the curtain, which simply showed some like psychedelic hallucination type effects on the screen, sort of like a pre-show warning that an overdose had happened, and obviously you'd overdose during this trial, and that's where the genuine experience now begins. The doctor returns, however, in a different form than before. Obviously you're now basically hallucinating, and the doctor is now wearing a baby's mask, like quite a terrifying baby's mask, got fake breasts and a strap-on dildo. The doctor comes and grabs me and says, right, it's time to get up. But the doctor grabbed my hand, made me grab the dildo. I went to go and grab my carrier bag with my hoodie in it. And then the doctor led me into the next room, where I was greeted with basically it was like a lunatic asylum, and I was in a room with a patient who was very crazy, very in my face, very touchy-feely, immediately started touching me, asking me where the drugs are, checking down my tracksuit bottoms, asked me to take my t-shirt off that I had on, then asked me to lie down on the floor, and then proceeded to urinate on me. Obviously, it wasn't real. It was a fake substance. I can only assume was like salt water, because a lot of it landed on my face. Then I was proceeded to have my head shoved into a toilet with a lot of fake poo. Covered in it, and then the water splashed in my face. I was then asked to pick up my bag to then go under the bed that was in the room, through a very narrow crawl space where I kind of had to stay prone throughout it. As I was crawling through there, I ended up getting shocked from the floor by a static shock effect that was in there, which was it caught me by surprise, that's for sure. But it was good. I can't lie. Where I then proceeded on to the next room. Now, this room was rather interesting. I have heard in other people's run-throughs this was a male, but as I exited through the crawl space, I was presented by a dildo on the floor with a lot of looked to be used condoms, and a very attractive woman in basically what can only be described as lingerie with high heels and a whip. I was told to kneel on the floor, still no t-shirt on, t-shirt now is now in the bag with my hoodie, and I was told to masturbate or wank the dildo that was in front of me with lube, which had lubricant on it. After that, this attractive woman then pulled out another larger dildo and asked me to then proceed to wank that. Then asked me to close my eyes and pulled out a fleshlight. I only knew that because obviously I kind of kept a little eye open. You know what it's, you know how it is. Because I wanted to basically know what was happening. She did tell me off for that. She did catch me. And asked me to finger the fleshlight, which was a unique experience, I have to say. And then asked me to stand up against the wall and bend over, and proceeded to whip me. Not hard. It was perfectly acceptable and fine. Not an issue at all. She asked me if I liked it. I said yeah. But after that, she then asked me to sit down on the sofa that was in the room. Which I did. She then proceeded to straddle me and pretend to have sex, like as if we were having sex, and then said, after about 10 seconds, that's the worst sex she's ever had. Told me to lay on my back, and then proceeded to kick me through the sofa. So basically, I was like laid flat, and then the back of the sofa, I was like kicked through the sofa, which was pretty unique experience, I have to admit. I guess it's a cred, you could say. And then on to the next room. Just want to quickly say that some of these rooms might be a little bit of out of order. My memory's not the best, but you are experiencing all of these rooms inside of this experience. But in this room, I was in a barber's. It's very apparent with each room what you going to be basically doing in that room. It was very clear that it was a barber's. It was themed that way, with a barber's chair, that the actor in there looked like a barber. Asked me to take a seat and started to check my beard out. I called Mercy, so I used the safe word, which is Mercy at this point, but I said Mercy, but only for the beard. You have free reign over my eyebrows, my non-existent hair. Although they did proceed to, if you can see that, cut an E into the back of my head and place a waxing strip across my stomach and my chest. He didn't remove them though; he left them there. They stayed on throughout the entire experience. And then told me to go and stand in basically a padded box, very claustrophobic padded box, for maybe a minute. He did say before he closed the door there was a emergency button that can open the doors if for whatever reason if I needed to. But when the doors closed, a very cold fan started to blow cold air onto me. Like I say, for probably about a minute. I don't know how long I was actually in there. And then the door to the next room opened behind me. Now, in this room, it was very apparent what this room was. It was just lots of shelves filled with bugs and insects, a table in the centre filled with lots of mealworms, and tubs of mealworms, basically. And I think they were meant to be like fake maggots and things. However, there was an actor in there talking about bugs, things like that, then proceeded to give me a little pill pot. He had a pill pot as well. We cheersed, and this pill pot contained actual mealworms. So I... down the hatch and chewed and gipped a lot. I didn't swallow. I decided to spit them out into my hand, and the actor just looked at me and just slapped them out of my hand. So all this chewed mealworm just went all over the place, although there was plenty of that on the floor in there anyway. And then after that, He asked me to close my eyes. I didn't immediately, and I saw he had something that looked like a creepy crawly in his hand, and said it was going towards my ear, and so told me to close my eyes, and I just called Mercy. Anything to do with eyes and ears, it makes me weak at the knees. I don't know why. I love watching horror movies such as Saw, for example. I'm a big fan of the Saw franchise. But anything that is related to eyes and ears, it gets me. I don't know why, but I just called it there. So he then basically just did a little bit more acting, talking about insects and bugs, and then asked me to move on to the next room. In this next room, I was greeted by a very loud and angry army sergeant, I guess we could call them, who asked me to do many press-ups, then sit on an electric chair. On the hands, I had to put my hands down on the armrest. On the ends were plates, which obviously were shot to shock me. I think I got three shocks. After that, I was then asked to stand up against the wall, as if I was about to be executed, and close my eyes. At this point, I mercied. I used the safe word. The actor did a fantastic job of actually being rather intimidating in that section. And the idea of when he turned me on, I had no idea what he was going to do. And I don't know why, but he just, I wussed out of that section. So I'm a bit annoyed, but I later found out you just get shot with a BB gun, which I would have had no problem with. But the actor did a great job of actually making me feel intimidating in that section. So props to them. And then after that, I was basically then moved on to the next room. In this room, I entered into a child's bedroom with a clown in the corner, just sat there staring at me. And there was a cot, lots of toys and things and stuff on the walls. The clown proceeded to ask me to stand against the wall. He painted me up all across my beard and my head. He got UV paint and just splashed it all across me. He then asked me to get into the cot, basically as if I'll go into bed, and put me in with toys and started to rock me, threw water on me. Then asked me to play little games like find certain colours in the room and things like that. And if I got them wrong, he would throw water on me. Then asked me to get out of the cot and proceeded to wrap me in bubble wrap. Well, not bubble, sorry, cling film, not bubble wrap. Many times, probably about 10 times, I was pretty dizzy, and he asked me to do that twice. So at that point, my arms were I couldn't do anything with my arms. My carrier bag was being thrown around that much in the maze or experience that it was ripped. So my clothes were put down my back and the carrier bag put on my head. And then after that, which was it was in there quite a long time. I have to admit that was probably the weakest room. It felt like I was in there for a long period with not a lot going on in terms of effects, so to speak. The actor did a fantastic job, though, of working that time in there with me. Really good acting and genuinely made me feel a little on edge. And then after that, I was asked to crawl out on my knees, which I exited Enola into the gift shop. And that's the end of the experience. Overall, Enola is just simply crazy and generally drug fueled. It's something I've not experienced before. It's something I would happily experience again and again, no questions asked. And I know that the team over at Walsall are so, they love feedback and they work from it. I did make them aware that I did think the last room was the weakest part of the maze. I keep saying maze, it's not a maze, it's an experience. I do think that something might need to be just changed in that last bit. There are probably small critiques I would have in other sections. Maybe the eating section, maybe kind of getting another insect that you might be able to add into the eating section. I don't know, I got mealworm, but maybe adding another one in there. It feels like sometimes some sections the actors are having to pick up on the lack of anything in that room, if that makes sense. But the actors were all phenomenal. They did fantastic job. And just overall, 9 out of 10 from me for Enola. It is something I want to do year in and just every year, just for the foreseeable. And I would love to see how it develops and improves over the years. And I can only see it getting better as well. But if you are into intense, funny, weird, drug-fueled, scare experiences, then this is a one for you. And I highly recommend going down and checking it out. Walsall Scare Maze has Scare House and Enola, both separate attractions. I aren't gonna do a Scarehouse review. I'm gonna link my good friend's review once that's available by Theme Park Jam. Those guys put out some fantastic blog reviews about it, these kind of types of experiences, and I feel that they would probably write up something better than I can actually speak. And they did not. They didn't personally experience Enola, whereas I did. So. I decided to make this a dedicated video to Enola. But overall, Walsall Scare Maze during Halloween and for Christmas, the Chris Massacre event has been a 10 out of 10 every time. And it just keeps getting better and better. But Enola, it's I could possibly be the biggest fan of Enola. I do think you need some, if you're watching this, Walsall, you need some Enola merch, like a hoodie or something like that, because I love the logo, so I would love to see that put onto some merch alongside your Walsall Scare Maze hoodies as well, which I do need to actually get one purchased. I just never seem to have money when I go there. But anyway, if you've got this far into the review, I really, really do appreciate it. Thank you very much. I just want to quickly say a big thank you to Walsall Scare Maze for having me down to check out the event. It was an absolute pleasure, and I can't wait to return next year during Halloween. I'll be the first one there specifically for Enola again. But yeah, thank you very much for watching if you've got this far, like I said, and all the best. See you in a bit.